أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. لا ترتيب الدرس بين الخطبة العربية شوي. English درس شوي.
English first and then Arabic.
Okay, then after the second, after Adhan, then the Arabic خطبة.
No, Adhan is second one.
So now this is the خطبة or
English,
just درس.
Then Arabic and then Namaz.
Okay. ما شاء الله, every masjid they have their own ترتيب. And all of it, inshallah, khair. I apologize. There was accident, and I took other exit. And then my GPS does not know, but 95. So, alhamdulillah, finally, Allah Azza wa Jalla give us tawfiq to be here, inshallah. My dear respected brothers, sisters, elders, and mothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. There is two kinds of khutbah. The people, they have two manhaj. Manhaj Abu Hanifa rahimahullah says the khutbah, all of it Arabic language. So every language other than Arabic language is not khutbah. Our madhab al-Shafi'iyah, they said the khutbah has five main parts. If you do it in Arabic, then after that, any language you speak, it's okay. The first thing you start with Alhamdulillah. Then complete ayah. Complete ayah in Arabic. Then Salah ala Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then to urge the people about taqwa, and then you make dua. So these things, if you say it in Arabic, then after that, you can speak with any language the people, they understand. And Alhamdulillah, I am Arab. Some people, they say, if he's not Arab, they said, he does not know how to speak Arabic. That's why he wants to speak in English. But my English is half and half anyway. So my Arabic is much better than English. But I prefer in the khutbah that the imams to make the five things in Arabic, then deliver their message in English. Because the people, they don't attend but the khutbah till Jummah. Khutbah al-Jum'ah, mashallah, there is no space. And this is the time for the imams to deliver their khutbah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ. There is no Nabi Allah sent but with the tongue of his people to explain to them. Now if I speak 2 hours in Arabic, how many people they will understand? MashaAllah, the voice of the Sheikh was beautiful. This is what he understood. The voice of the Sheikh is beautiful. What's the message behind it? He does not know anything. So my brothers, alhamdulillah, this manhaj is khair and this manhaj is khair. And any masjid, follow any of the 2 tariqah, I will follow it to respect the masjid and the responsible people of the masjid and the imam of the masjid. So inshallah, I will explain some in English. Then I will deliver all the khutbah in Arabic language بإذنالله تعالى. There is moment Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam passed through. We never in our life experience it. And wallahi ya ikhwan, alhamdulillah, the deen these days easy. Wallahi, even in America, alhamdulillah, the deen is easy. The people, mashallah, they come to khutbatul jum'ah. If the AC not on, where is the responsible people? It's very hot here. Subhanallah, we complain. Why? Because the AC is not working proper. It's hot little bit. We don't remember the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Makkah to Medina, 450 kilometers on the camels. And how many moments he has shade on the top of his head, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, when we remember these things, we should thank Allah Azza wa Jal that He gave us this ni'mah. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, he was asked, is there any moment Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed through, it was very hard on him? He said, yes. He said in Mecca, when he was making sujood, when he was in the sujood, there is one shaitan of the kafirin, his name Uqba bin Abi Mu'ayyid. La'natullahi ta'ala alayhi. This man has ahwal with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, situations. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ نَبِيٍ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدُونَ. توحيد لله سبحانه وتعالى. وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. Every Nabi has a special عدو from المجرمين, from those criminals. So this man, he came to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم while he was in the sujood. And he put his thawb around the neck of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he choked him. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, by Allah al-Azim, I felt my eyes will pop out of my face. No one in that time dared to come except Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He came and he pushed him away and he said, أَتَقْتُلُونَ رَجُلًا أَن يَقُولَ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ. Are you killing a man saying, my Rabb is Allah? Other occasion, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sujood, look how much sabr, ya ikhwan. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do you think he is coward? He cannot defend himself? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah gave him the strength of 40 men together. If he smack him once, he will kill him. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, when he saw the Egyptian fighting with the Israeli, he just told him, stop. He hit him on his ribs. Where the hand of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam reached, all the bones was broken. He died immediately. He killed him. But it's not intention. He said, he just told him, stop. But he did not think that he has special power. Those anbiya, Allah gave them a special power. But the sabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the rahmah. Abu Jahl was sitting with his group and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praying in the sujood. And the sujood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, long sujood. How do I know it's long? From the story itself. Abu Jahl, he said, who among you can bring the internal of the camel of the tribe of so and so, bring it and put it on the top of his head while he is in his sujood? Imagine they went to the other tribe and they brought the internal of the she camel, and he is still in the sujood, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But look to our sujood, mashallah. You see our sujood? Jaldi jaldi karo. Tick tick, like the rooster when he takes the seeds. Like the roosters. Subhanal Khalaq al-Azim. So Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, in Hadith Sahih al-Bukhari, he said, by Allah al-Azim, if I have a tribe to defend me, I will move it, but I cannot even come close to it, to him. Because he felt if he come close to defend Rasulullah, he will be killed. And Rasulullah stayed in the sujood while the internal of the she camel on the top of his head. Who moved it? Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, and she was very young. She came and she moved it and she started crying. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال لا تبكي يا بني لا تبكي يا بني فإن الله ناصر أباك. My daughter, don't cry, don't cry. Allah will give your father the victory. Don't cry. This is the sabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After Mecca was closed, he went to Taif to see maybe inshallah somebody will accept Islam. But Taif was even worse than Mecca in that time. He went to the leaders, Abdi Alayl and his brothers, they are three, the leaders of the tribe of Thaqif. One of them, he said to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are Nabi, you are higher than me, I cannot talk to you. And if you are liar, you are lower than me, I cannot talk to you. So anyway, I'm not talking to you. Shaitan, they know how to talk. If you are Nabi, you are so high, I cannot talk to you. If you are liar, you are very low, I cannot talk to you. So get out of here. Not even that, they told their children to stone Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alhamdulillah, until now, no one of us, for the sake of Allah, was stoned. Wallahi. Always, especially Mawlana's, mashallah. Here, Mawlana, the best plate for the food for Mawlana. So, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was walking, and behind him, Zayd ibn Haritha radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the only one was with him. And he was trying to defend Rasulullah with his hands from the stones. His feet, his head was bleeding, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imagine Rasulullah himself, the people stone him, his own people. Then he said, I did not catch myself. He was just lost. Means he has so much pain and concerns, he did not even think about himself, but he reached a place, they call it Ra'su al-Tha'alib. Ra'su al-Tha'alib, there is beautiful book. The name of the book, Mu'jam al-Buldan. Any city in the previous days, it has description in book. The author, his name, Yaqut al-Hamawi. If somebody wants to know about any place. So when I read about Ra's al-Tha'alib, I said, let me go to see how far Ra's al-Tha'alib from al-Ta'if. You know how far was it? They said Ra's al-Tha'alib place away from Mecca 60 kilometers. 60 kilometers while Rasulullah was walking, ya ikhwan. Imagine. 60 kilometers. Then he said, suddenly I have seen at the top of my head a cloud shading Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. In the cloud, Jibreel عليه السلام. Ya Rasulullah, laqad sami'a rabbuka maqalata qawmika lak. Ya Rasulullah, your Rabb heard the reply of your people to you. And he sent with me the angel, the one who controlled the mountains. Order him whatever you want, he will obey you. Then the angel, he started talking, Assalamu alayka ya Rasulullah, wa alaykum assalam. Ya Rasulullah, if you want me to crush them between two mountains, I will do that. Now, imagine, ya ikhwan, ourselves when we have, for example, a problem with somebody and we have the time to take revenge, do we hesitate? Allah ghair nikhrib baytu. Allah ghair nhat mutahtim. Wallahi. We have no hesitation. Now the time for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to finish all the kafirin in one word, between two mountains. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, La ya akhi ya Jibreel. No, my brother. No. Asa Allah. Insha'Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from their progeny, those people kafirin. If from them Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring people, they will worship Allah and they have no shirk. Asa Allah. I ask Allah from their children. An yukhrija min aslabihim man ya'budu Allah la yushriku bihi shay'a. Then Jibreel replied back and he said, لَقَدْ صَدَقَ مَنْ سَمَّاكَ رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Ya Rasulullah, the one who call you رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ is honest. رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. You are رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Those they are blowing buildings, killing people in the streets. Are they رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ? Wallahi, they are عَذَاب. And they break the images of Islam. They hurt Islam. Under the name of Islam, they destroy the name of Islam. And guess what? As they said in English, guess what? Abu Jahl, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the Fir'aun of this ummah, Abu Jahl, the Fir'aun of this ummah. If from Abu Jahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought Sahabi Jalil, his name Ikrimah. And Ikrimah, he was all his life fighting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All his life. Then finally, even he left Mecca when they conquered Mecca. To where? To Ta'if. The Ta'if, alhamdulillah, became Muslimin. Then he left the Ta'if. Where? To Hunayn. Hunayn became Sahaba. Where to go? So he took the ship. Where he wants to go? He wants to go to Jordan. Then, when he took the ship, they want to leave. That he was the last passenger. The last passenger, Ikrimah. He wants to get rid of Mecca, khalas. He does not want to become Muslim. But look, subhanallah, rahmah. Rahmatullah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the captain, he said, oh people, before we leave, there is an announcement. He said, yes. Then he said, when there is so many waves and we are in danger, don't ask but Allah. We tried all the idol, does not work. The only one helps us if we are in deep trouble is the only Allah. Then he said, stop. He said, what? He said, this is my problem with Muhammad since 18 years. Now you are telling me? Thank you. I'm going back and I become Muslim. But before he became Muslim, his wife was following him and she was Sahabiya radiallahu ta'ala anha. She came and said, Ya Rasulullah, Ikrimah is a good man. If he becomes Muslim, is he safe? Because Ikrimah was from the five people, Rasulullah he said, chop their heads anywhere. He was, before Islam, shaitan. Rasulullah he said, if he becomes Muslim, he is safe. She said, Ya Rasulullah, but he will be so scared. Is there any evidence? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is my amama is evidence. Take my amama to him. Ya Ikrimah, you are safe, come. He said, what's the evidence? She said, the evidence is the amama of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he came and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ikrimah coming Muslim, he told the Sahaba, if he comes, don't ever curse his father. Imagine, don't curse Abu Jahl. Even though Allah cursed Abu Jahl. But ya ikhwan, the akhlaq of Islam, don't curse his father. When he became Sahabi, ya ikhwan, those people, they are changed 100%. Wallahi, those people, when they became Sahaba, they became awliya lillah. Ikrimah and the battle of Yarmouk. Ikrimah, he looked like Khalid. They are very brave. They are knights. So his horse was killed. Then he started fighting on his legs. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, "Ya Ikrimah, you are one of the people. We rely on you. You are brave. Go jump on horse. Don't walk like this. Any horse will kill you now." What's his reply? He said, "Ya Abdullah ibn Umar." Abdullah ibn Umar al-Khattab. "You and your father, all your life, you were defending Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And myself and my father, we are fighting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So different, you are, mashallah, closer to Allah than me. You and your father, mashallah, always defending and with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Myself and my father, we are always against Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Leave me alone, inshallah. Today I will fight until I get the shahada." And he fought and until he became shaheed. Radiallahu ta'ala. You see? Those people, they are changed 100%. Abu Sufyan was fighting Islam. But once in one of Ghazawat, the arrow came between his eye and his skin, and he took his eye out. Nothing catching the eye but the vein. It's exactly what happened to Qatada radiallahu ta'ala anhu in the battle of Uhud. Qatada radiallahu ta'ala anhu, the same thing, the arrow came in his eye and his eye went out, but still the vein catching it. Then he came catching, carrying the eye, "Ya Rasulullah, my eye." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ya Qatada, atasbir walaka al-jannah." What do you have? Sabr, and Allah will take you to al-jannah. Qatada said, "Ya Rasulullah, I want al-jannah and I want my eye too." Other narration, he said, "Ya Rasulullah, inni hadithu ahdin bi'urs." "Ya Rasulullah, I am recently married. If I go back with one eye, my wife, she does not like it. So I, please save my eye and inshallah al-jannah too." So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took it with his mubarak hand and he put it back. And he put from his saliva on it. فَكَانَتْ أَفْضَلَ عَيْنَيْهِ وَأَحَدَّهُمَا نَظَرًا. It became the best of his two eyes and the strongest in the sighting among two horses, his eyes. And that I never have any sickness until he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Abu Sufyan, when he caught his eye, "Ya Rasulullah, my eye." Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the same, he said, "Ya Abu Sufyan, atasbir walaka al-jannah?" What happened? Abu Sufyan said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah." He took it out and he put it under his foot. "Yes, Ya Rasulullah, my eye under my feet, fi sabilillah." So those, ya ikhwan, the Sahaba, became Sahaba because of the sabr of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me of taking your time and delaying you. Inshallah, I will make the khutbah in Arabic, inshallah, in a moment, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair, wa sallallahu wa sallam, wa barakasna Muhammad wa sahabi alayhi wa sallam. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله نبي بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك ولا يتنكبها إلا ضال اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فيا عباد الله إن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول المولى جل جلاله في كتابه العظيم وهو أصدق القائلين: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله ربنا ومولانا العظيم وبلغ رسوله الصادق الأمين ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة المؤمنون، يقول رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: والله لتموتن كما تنامون ولتبعثن كما تستيقظون ولتجازن بالإحسان إحسانا وبالشر شرا وإنها للجنة أبدا أو النار أبدا. ويقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: والله ما بعد هذه الدار من دار إلا الجنة أو النار. فيا أيها الإخوة والأخوات، البدار البدار والاستعداد الاستعداد للقاء رب العالمين. الدنيا ساعة فاجعلها لله طاعة، وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول ربي لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين. ولن يؤخر الله نفسا إذا جاء أجلها والله خبير بما تعملون. أسأل الله جل جلاله أن يرزقني وإياكم الاستقامة والقبول واتباع الرسول برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه كان الأوابين غفورا. All the Arabic language is the same language. The khutbah, all of it Arabic language. So this is the jalsat al-istiraha. The English was not khutbah. After in alhamdulillah, this is the khutbah. So now this is jalsat al-istiraha, jazakum Allah khair. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa man wala. Ikhwat al-iman, ittaqu Allah, fa innahu kafa makan. فحالنا وحال المسلمين في كل مكان لا يرضى به إنسان. اتقوا الله سبحانه فإن جميعا بين يديه موقوفون وعلى أعمالنا محاسبون وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: يقف العبد بين يدي الله يوم القيامة ليس بينه وبين ربه ترجمان، فينظر أيمن منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم، وينظر أشأم منه فلا يرى إلا ما قدم، وينظر بين يديه فلا يرى إلا النار تلقاء وجهه، فاتقوا النار ولو بشق تمرة. ويقول جبريل للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: يا رسول الله، عش ما شئت فإنك ميت، وصاحب من شئت فإنك مفارقه، واعمل ما شئت فإنك مجزي به، واعلم أن شرف المؤمن قيامه بالليل وعزه استغناؤه عن الناس. واعلموا رحمكم الله أن الله عز وجل أمركم بأمر عميم بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكة قدسه وثلث بالمؤمنين من جنه وإنسه، فقال تعالى: ولم يزل آمرا حكيما، تعظيما لقدر نبيه وتكريما: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. لبيك اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. مولانا أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. من والانا فواله ومن عادانا فعاده. من أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه إلى كل خير، ومن أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فاجعل كيده في نحره واجعل تدميره تدبيره يا رب العالمين. اللهم فرج كرب المسلمين في كل مكان، واحقن دماء المسلمين في كل مكان، وأعز الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان، وأذل الشرك والمشركين في كل مكان. اللهم هيئ لهذه الأمة أمر رشد يعز فيه أهل طاعتك ويذل فيه أهل معصيتك، ويؤمر فيه بالمعروف وينهى فيه عن المنكر. ربنا أصلح لنا في ذرياتنا إنا تبنا إليك وإنا من المسلمين. اللهم اختم لنا بالصالحات وتوفنا على الإيمان. لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا همّا إلا فرجته، ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا والآخرة إلا قضيتها ويسرتها، يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين. إخوة الإيمان، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم، واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، وأقم الصلاة إن صلاة على الفحشاء والمنكر، ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
استقيم إلى الصلاة يرحمنا وإياكم الله. اعتدلوا تراصوا رحم الله.